Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at how you can add extra bones to your character in Character Creator 4 after generating your rig in AccuRIG, so that you can maintain the humanoid model specifications and still add additional other bones and assign them as spring bones or other bone types. Let's start off by exporting our AccuRIG humanoid character to Blender so that we can add some additional bones. You can see this coyote character model on the screen has a stiff tail due to the fact that there are no bones in it, which we can manipulate. To prepare for export into Blender, I'm going to remove the test animation and make sure the character is in a T-pose, then go up to Export Clothed Character from the File menu. Since we're exporting to Blender in this case, I'll choose that target tool preset and continue on to export it as an FBX named Coyote. We can then move on to Blender and import in that same FBX. We don't need to worry about shading and materials here, since we're just adding bones, so first I'll ensure I'm in the perpendicular side view, bone display is set to front, and then enter into edit mode. From there, I can select the CC base hip bone in the layer panel and press the E hotkey for extrude. Then left click to create our first tailbone. I can repeat that to get three major tailbones and then go back into object menu to prepare for export. I'll press A to select all, then export that same FBX from the file menu in Blender. Once that's done, we can go ahead and re-import the character into Character Creator. I'm going to delete the old Coyote character here, then press Create Character to start on our updated one with the tailbones. I need to select the humanoid option, and from there enter into characterization mode to define all of the bones. If you're not familiar with characterization mode, please check out the dedicated tutorial on our Realism Courses page. After I've mapped the bones properly, I'll exit characterization mode. From there, I need to assign the materials manually by dragging them from Explorer to their respective spots in the Material tab. Strength for the normal map should be set to 100. From there, I can simply apply a test motion to see the results. You'll notice that there is still no effect on the tail of the characters, as we still need to assign skin weights for those newly added bones. Again, ensure that your character is set to humanoid and head into the Bone Manager. Initially, you still won't be able to see those bones you added as they are set to unused bones by default. To find them, simply go over to the filters on the left to only show unused bones, then select all of the bones we created stemming from the CC base hip 01 and click on Used to assign them as used bones. They're now assigned to your character model. But if we go over to the Edit Motion Layer tool, you'll notice that when I try to rotate the bones, that the mesh will not follow along. This takes us to our last step, which is manually painting the skin weights for our new bones, which we need to do in order for them to drive movement of the mesh. Let's start off by going into Skin Weights mode. From here, when I select the CC Base Hip 01, you can see that it controls the entire tailbone hierarchy, and the tailbones haven't been assigned any skin weights at all yet. Therefore, I'm going to start at the very last bone node on the tail, ensure it's selected, and start by painting a full weight value onto the tip of the character's tail. From there, I need to progressively decrease the strength and paint around the diameter of the tail to create a slowly weakening gradient as I progress further down towards the connection with the origin point of the next bone in the hierarchy. It's important to remember the visual colors that represent the basic skin weight values. You can see how they progress in this reference image here. White and warmer colors will represent stronger skin weight values, while black and colder colors will be the opposite. You'll want to ensure that you also use the smooth paint operation to help create a smoother gradient blend between the values you've painted as well. You'll want to continue on using the same technique for the other bones as well until they all have skin weight definitions. It's natural for values to overlap, and you may need to do some trial and error testing with test motions to achieve the ideal result in the end. Once we're satisfied, we can exit skin weight mode and enter into the Edit Pose panel once again to see that the rotation results have now been fixed. You can also assign these extra bones as spring bones so that they produce a natural bouncy spring effect when the rest of the body is animated. To do so, simply go over to the Edit Spring mode, select the bone you want to assign spring values to, and click the Active box. You can learn more about spring bones and their various effects in the dedicated tutorial on our ReLoos and Courses page. From there, you can assign a test motion, and that's all there is to it. This is, of course, a very simple example of assigning extra bones to your humanoid characters, but feel free to explore yourself and try out more complex and exciting bone structures. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you in the next video.